What do I get for my birthday? What do I get for my... Oh. Oh. Oh, yes. I almost saw some stuff. Let me move all this. Move right out of my life. You better move. Move. I get all that myself. And I feel like that is a very important thing when a woman is independent.
My mouth's a moist and the liquid is just going everywhere.
That's trigger points. Everybody has trigger points. Let's just be honest. Those are my trigger points.
Yoplait yogurt is like...
I hit every single option possible. Baby, I did like baking. I think if you... Even though that's just a label. We're trans women, but we're still human at the end of the day. We want what everybody else wants, and that's just to be loved and accepted. That's all we damn want. Yes. Love and acceptance.
This is what we're going to do because I feel that I'm getting out of my character. So, this is what we're going to do.
It's time to be alive, isn't it? Mind that we came a long way.
Hey, what's the tea, YouTube? Come on. Bust down, Tatiana. Look, go ahead and like, share, subscribe. I know these two little pieces, they just keep sticking up because I was really getting ready to take my wig off. But I said, let me make a little video because I do want to get something off my chest. I want to talk about something very quickly. you can almost assume who I'm about to speak to, but it's to my chocolate people. I got another problem. I got a problem. What that man say? I got a wife. How you got a problem? You got a wife and a girlfriend. Yeah, you got a problem. All right, you fucking cheater. I grew up listening to the blues. But seriously, pronouns. Now, I be getting a lot of backlash when I be speaking about things, but I want everyone to understand when I speak about things, it's always from my experiences. And it's always my opinion and how I view things. So you can't get upset with me for having a motherfucking opinion. Because, bitch, you got one. Y'all be quick to tell me how y'all feel in my comments. Call me all type of horrible names. Which I don't understand if you feel any type of disdain towards me. Why are you watching me, baby? Ain't nobody forcing you to watch Maya Ray, baby. Go watch somebody else. Bitch, go watch your mother. Go make sure she's all right. Go check on her. Your daddy or something. Your children. Go check on somebody else. You ain't got to watch me. I'm fine. I'm cool. I want people watching me to want to watch me, bitch. You ain't got to watch me. But anyway, this is for the black people. What is the problem with pronouns? Now, I'm a realist. I'm probably one of the realest bitches you would ever come in contact with. When I look in the mirror, I see a trans woman. I don't see a biological woman. Calling it what it is, it's no T. And this is me talking about myself. I don't see a biological woman when I look in the mirror. I see a trans woman. She's cute. I definitely don't see a fucking man. But I don't see a biological woman either. I see a woman who's obviously, she was obviously born, you know, a little extra yang, yang, yang between her legs. But she's doing what she got to do and she getting back. Okay? She getting on back. Why in the fuck? I get you ignorant ass black motherfuckers always want to refer to me as he. Oh, look at him with his nails. Oh, look. I'm a server. You know I talk about y'all black ass not tipping, but that's a conversation for another video. This is about pronouns. So by me being a server, first and foremost, fuck me being a server. I have been in customer service since the age of 19. I have been in customer service a very long time. I've always dealt with the public. And don't get me wrong, other races sometimes do refer to me as he, and I correct them, and that's that. It's boom, it's over. From my experiences, it has always been an issue with the black motherfuckers. It's almost like they get mad at me that I'm correcting them and trying to help them understand what are my preferred pronouns. Like, bitch, this is my motherfucking life. I'm telling you what I go by. I go by she, her, ma'am, miss, lady, queen. I go by all that.
And I do understand everyone does not agree with my lifestyle. And that's fine. That is fine. You don't have to agree with my lifestyle. But also understand, by you not agreeing with my lifestyle, communication has been gone. I thought I broke a nail. We don't have to talk. We don't have to speak. You don't have to speak to me. I don't have to speak to you. We can just keep on living on this beautiful planet we call Earth and keep it going. You don't have to see me, and I do not have to see you. It's fine. You don't have to agree with Maya Ray's lifestyle. I promise you, I'm going to sleep real good at nighttime, each and every night, might I add. But if you wish to have any type of exchange of words with me, I don't give a damn if it's a hello. Respect will start the whole thing off. But find out what it means to me, R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Oh, you gonna respect the doll if you wish to be in her fucking presence and speaking with her. And if not, that's fine. I get it. Everyone's not going to be for me. I get that. But for the ones who are for me, bitch, it's my pronouns. It's she, her, and ma'am. Girl. And it frustrates me so bad when you cry. You know what I'm thinking about right here? It's mainly black bitches. Now, I don't want nobody to get no feathers ruffled or tussled or whatever. We're going to call it what it is. It's always the black bitches who have the problem with respecting me. Black men always, for the most part, always refer to me as she and her. But I do realize a black man, because you know, a large population of the BL community is the black man. I do realize when they're around other people, oh, that's a N-word, you know, that's a dude, all that kind of stuff. I catch that. So when they're around, when they have an audience, they like to perform and act as if they don't respect the pronouns. But when it's he and I, oh, it's she, her, ma'am, you, bae, and all that kind of shit. But when you're around Teresa Getaways, or like Angela, and I'm just throwing out random names, y'all. Don't nobody get offended. Just throwing out random names. When you're around the women, you can't get the pronouns together. I got a dude like that. Well, now he's not my dude, but I know a dude like that. He always refers to me as Maya and she and her, black guy. But when I see him out and about, he refers to me as my dead name. Honey, I gave him a good reading, honey. He never did it again. Don't try to play with me, baby. You want to play? You go get one of them fucking chaps and bring them to the motherfucking park and y'all play all day long. But you don't play with her. Spare no one, okay? It's always the black community. My mother, love her to death, my favorite person on the planet besides myself. I had to correct her, and I will still correct her if need be. When she sees another trans person in public and stuff, she'll go, oh, his makeup's cute and all that kind of stuff. I say, mama, don't do that. Her, don't do that. Not my mama, no ma'am. She corrects herself after I correct her, of course. But I have no problem correcting my mother. So let me tell you bitches something. If you think, if I correct my mama, you know damn well I'm going to correct you hoes. Each and every time. But it's only a few times I'm going to correct you before I start cursing you out. Because the first time it's a mistake. The second time, bitch, you fucking up. Third time, strike you out of this motherfucker. You out. O-U-T. This is mainly to the black people, because other races have been corrected and they will correct themselves, and other races will be corrected and sometimes they still say he, but they, you know, it's very few. I'm being very honest. It's very few. Like, the percentage is very small. It's always my fellow African Americans who has a problem with pronouns. And let's take away being, what is it called when your pronouns are they and them? Let's take that away for just a moment, temporarily, y'all. Let's say I walk to your table, giving you all this. I have the lashes, I have the makeup on. Okay. So you see a person walking up to you, presenting themselves as a female. Nothing clicks in your motherfucking head and say, this bitch want to be called her and ma'am. Y'all be quick to tell me I want to be a woman. Okay. So if I want to be a motherfucking woman, bitch, talk to me like one. Bitch. But if we're going to use your motherfucking logic and say he wants to be a woman anyway. Okay. So since he wants to be a woman, talk to him like a motherfucking woman. Or don't talk to him at all. It's so simple, my love. I promise you. he won't lose no sleep. Oh, that's a cute picture. Bitch, Maya, you giving it to him. Yes. Excuse my dress. I know I wore this dress another time on another video. I just got done doing something. I had no business. Girl, I've been drinking. I went out to Walk-Ons in Hammond with Miss Kim. We tried to get Kiosha to come, but that bitch. But, Kim, thank you, girl. I really needed this time. I don't know, though. I thank you for letting me get out the house or coming with me to get out the house. Girl, I got drunk I got tipsy and did something I regret. It's too late now, honey. I done swallowed it. It's too late. It's too late to apologize. Yeah, black motherfuckers always got a fucking problem with the trans community and the gays. Honey. You know, and then, look here. I'm gonna go. But I'm gonna get this off my chest. The black communities are so quick to throw out them Bible verses and shit. Oh, that's an abomination before God. Bitch, please, you having all these motherfucking children by different people and not one wedding ring on your index finger. Is it index finger or wedding finger? I wouldn't fucking know, but you need to know. You got all these motherfucking children out of wedlock. That's a motherfucking abomination before God. Having all this sex before marriage. Stealing is an abomination before God. Lying is an abomination before God. All that creeping your ass be doing, sleeping with their woman husband, sleeping with your motherfucking cousin, sleeping with your motherfucking other cousin, those are abominations before God. So before you can speak on what other people are doing in their motherfucking bedroom or wherever they decide to have sex at and with who, bitch, you go look at your motherfucking children. Tap them on the motherfucking shoulder and teach them right from wrong, because your raggedy ass ain't no better. That's why right now you can have your own personal family reunion each and every last motherfucking first and second Sunday in the motherfucking month, because all your children are cousins. Now that is an abomination before God. How you have sons and daughters and cousins all in the same motherfucking room, came out the same motherfucking womb? You nasty bitches. I'm gone. The clock me and I'm about to work. And that was just a little tipsy read, bitch. I've been drinking. Catch me when I'm sober so I can clean it up for you hoes. Yeah, I know who you are. Leave them girls alone, Maya. Don't shake the table, bitch. I have to read them down again, baby. I make myself laugh. Bitch, please. They know what the fuck I am, bitch. I hate a hating ass, insecure ass hoe, bitch. Yeah, it's funny, hoe. L-O fucking L. Bow. Oh, Lord. Yeah, respect your pronouns. Yeah, I feel like get your feelings hurt. I try to spare you bitches. I might like this little wig. Oh, this wig is so aggravating. I'm going to take it off. Subscribe.